terrible version of the theme song. Anyway, welcome to Wheel of Fortune. And it's over. Okay, welcome to Wheel of Fortune. One player versus the computer. Enter one. Player one, enter name. Okay. My characters. Yeah, I was honestly thinking about maybe doing it too for George Foreman, but. Or a three, I mean. But two just seemed a little bit better when I looked at the other twos. To be honest, I don't know. I wasn't paying attention. I know it's game tech, so maybe, maybe. Hey, Keklet, how you doing? Welcome on in. Yeah, George Foreman was a rough one. Yesterday was rough. But now we hopefully have a nice, easy thing to do. Is there no, no sound? No music? No music. Okay. Category is thing. There are no S's. How's your PS1 adventure going? Why? Why would you choose why? Free spin! Oh. Oh, okay. So you adjust your power by doing another free spin! $700. Okay, let's see something good. Let's see something good. It's a single R. We're gonna spin. Is the Tearing Saga game, is that a Japanese exclusive one? I'm gonna go with L. Oh. I have two free spins at my disposal too, which is really nice. My goal is to never buy vowels. I don't know, we'll see. Another free spin! Okay. I have three free spins. You guys never get another turn. 200. I think there's some D after that R. Spinning in. I'm glad the game is great. Oh, so it's mostly like, oh, okay, so it's like a Fire Emblem game. I like tactical RPGs more than normal ones. What about an N? No N. Yes, I do want to use my free spin. And we are going to spin again. DDI developed this one. Oh. They're not good though, are they? C? No C's. Free spin, yes. Welcome on in, Lord Arendt. How you doing? Fan translation, made by the original creator of Fire Emblem when he left Intelligent Systems. Oh, okay. Is there an F? F. That's free spin. It could be both. Could be both that Vanna is really large and... Oh, M's. We have a bad luck. Oh, you know what? I think I know what it is now. Just gonna solve it. Billiard. Oh no, it's not. Because that would be another. Oh shit. Okay, well, I'm done. Well, I guess T. Alright, I'll just end it. See, I don't know what it is. And there's also no S, so of course it's not billiard balls. Oh, I never started the timer either. I was so worried about my stream accuracy. Yes, please guess X. There's no difficulty setting for the computer that I could tell. There's just like one option. Billiard table. Clicking solve. Solve. What the? I was on the right track at least. Yay. That's the beauty of game show games on Twitch, though. You get to yell at your screen when I make stupid mistakes. But at least the computer is a complete idiot, so. Alright, round two, here we go. Gets to go first. Computer goes first. Hey, Raku. Poverty version. I mean, it's at least licensed. They can use a terrible version of the theme song instead of a complete ripoff. I made one bad guess and everyone's. Oh, there we go. Here 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 we go. S can be there. So glad they're eliminating that as an option. So I only have to play this 5 times at the minimum. And there's only 3 rounds per. It's the 2 rounds where you get to spin the wheel, and then it's the third round where, you know, like the host spins for you. And then you go to the prize round. So my goal is to win all 5 of the prizes that are on offer. Just because it'll be pretty quick. And that means I can delay playing Simpsons that much longer. Bit of bankruptcy yet, which is nice. And then yeah, feel free to yell out if you know it, but don't tell me what it is or give me hints as to what it might be. That one should help me a lot. And again, I'm gonna see if I can get through a game without buying a vowel. Like really trounce the comp. No D. Perhaps a B? They got something. That should tell me what it is. I'm not quite there. There's not much time between actions either. Like it really forces you to move quick. I know it. I don't know how to spell it. And so might not be right. Nope, definitely not right. It definitely does not end in an O. Well, if they can still spin though, that means there might be another consonant on the board. All right, I need to buy a letter. I hit the A button. It can't be right. Yes, it is. Okay. I thought the game was supposed to remove the spin option if there are only vowels left. But I guess it doesn't. The manual says it does, but it doesn't. Hey, Koos, how you doing? Welcome on in, everyone. We are playing a terrible version of Wheel of Fortune. How's Star Ocean coming along? For those that don't know, Koos is another one of our challengers doing the PlayStation 2. And been working on a RPG for quite a long time. Oh, RPGs are your jam? Not mine. Not mine. It really depends on the type of RPG. I need to have a non-random encounter style. Then I'll be okay. Over here, I'm doing the Game Boy Challenge. I'm working on every single US release Game Boy game on original cartridges. So I'm trying to collect the collection and then also beat them as I acquire them. That's a brand new poll, by the way, that Moobot link. So anyone who wants to vote on future games can do so at that link. Subscribers get 3 votes. Anyone else gets one. And so, yeah, if I don't own it, I can't play it and beat it, but I am working to acquire them all. Very close to one third of the entire library. Oh yeah, the Wheel of Fortune soundtrack, it does not sound. It sounds kind of like the actual theme song, but it's not very good. We're moving into round three of the first game. There's three rounds and then the championship prize round. And I'm going to try to win every single prize. There's five prizes. You get to pick which prize you go for. So, yeah. It shouldn't be too bad. I know what to look for when I'm going for the most expensive cartridges, though. So, it just sucks because pandemic pricing really ruined a lot. Like a lot of the games that used to be $15 and tw or $20 are now 50 to 100, and they are not coming back down because nobody wants to take the loss again. So that's the biggest problem for me, unfortunately. But I have plenty to play in the meantime. I have about 200 cartridges that have not yet been beaten. I still have to acquire about 140 more. But we'll get there. We'll get there. A tiny all this. So for people who are not very familiar with Wheel of Fortune, on this third round, you basically just get to pick one letter alternatively. Like the computer is going to pick something, and then I get to pick something, and then you have a limited amount of time to solve it. And just like most challengers, I'm doing everything blind, so I'm not looking for any hints or help on this one. But if you know it, feel free to just say you know it without saying what it is. Yeah, retro game prices are a little rough. I'm still trying to get some deals here and there. Ooh. Well, I don't know what the second word is yet, but I definitely know the first one. Really? There is a Z. That's the computer picking the junk letters. I don't know what that is. Oh, I might know what it is. Here we go. We're good. We're good. We're good. Context clues, right? So now I get to solve it. I love all this music, right? Yay! Yeah, hate it when you see a game for $100 and think, that's not too bad. Especially when it used to be like 50 bucks. Alright, so I've won all three rounds. We're moving on to the championship of the first game. Alright, so here are my choices for prizes. We've got $25,000, Hawaii, a Porsche, a cruise, or a sailboat. I think I'm gonna go with the crappiest one first. We're doing sailboat and working our way through. We'll save the cash for last. But I have to win this too. I have to solve this puzzle. All right, and this is like old school Wheel of Fortune rules, where they don't give you any letters for free. I'm gonna say a C, and then we will do Oh. See, help me out. I think I know it. Think if I wouldn't have picked the C, and if I would have picked an A instead of the O, I would have still gotten it, but. Oh, good, and I disconnected right at the win. That's nice. I'm locally recording, so the people who are watching on YouTube, they know for sure that I won. So, one down. I'll wait for the stream to come back up to advance the screen more. Am I back? If you have to ask if you lost me, you probably did. The question is, how many times did you lose me? Am I still gone? Still freaking gone. Maybe I can just switch back. Okay. It might be live. So I am locally recording it. But yeah, if you have to ask if you lost me, then yes, I've been lost. I'm having a lot of internet issues today, unfortunately. So I will be back in like a minute after if after it goes away. I'm just waiting for internet to reboot on me. But yeah, it was Carl Sagan who said I was right, and the sailboat, the same picture proves that I win the prize somehow. I don't know. I'm gonna wait to start up the next game until I know for sure I'm not losing connection again, because it shows I'm unstable right now. Might be okay. We'll give it a shot. I don't know. Internet sucks. Let's move on to game two. Okay, it just goes to the title screen first. It's like Twitch didn't want to show my win. I re-enter my name and everything. Can't just like continue as a returning champion. Don't get to see like the total amount of money I won. Fictional character. I think I kind of lucked out though. No T's. The first letter is not T, or the second word is not T. That's surprising. But one of them would be T. Yeah, I definitely might lose a couple games on the final round. So, yeah, it's not the Batman. Not this time. Second word is not and. Not Dawn. Taint Dawn. Oh, computer went bankrupt. I like how it says boo at the top. I have yet to hit a bankrupt. L. We're spinning. Go for that R. Nobody's going for the R. Reynold McDonald. Won't be surprised if they go for the Y. Rayman Raving Rabbids. Old Ray. M's. Well, I might go for the Y. I did jinx myself. It was bound to happen. I can't go through 5 games without hitting a bankrupt. I'm gonna go with the P first, and then we'll try the Y. Oh, okay. It would not have been. Let's get some more money than just $200, though. This is where hubris could come back to bite me. I got 2 more consonants on the board. I could go for money. I mean, the computer is pretty dumb. Get for greedy. Enjoy your $100. I think if you solve it with no money, don't you get like $500 or something? Like, it honestly might be more beneficial to me monetarily to do this. Nope. It gave me nothing. It gave me nothing. Awesome. Well, crap. Alright, well, I learned that now. I think in the actual game show they give you like some cash if you solve with $0. Could go for some background music in this. That's a high dollar value. See those T's? E's. And it's an ing, not a thing. I might know what it is. No, I don't. Never mind. I was thinking jumping jack, but that would mean there'd have to be a J in the front. And that did not happen. But let's see if there are. Oh, jeez. Taking that S yet? I should probably take the S. Doesn't help me a whole lot. Alright, so the second word is definitely not Jack. Are there ends? No. Don't know it yet. I'm thinking it's mostly vowels right now. I don't know. I still don't know. There's, yeah, very limited time to think. It's, the countdown is a quick one. There would be. My inclination is that the second word is June, but it might not be. Should probably just buy a vowel, even though like it goes against my whole policy. Oh, the last word could be junk. Oh God, I hope it's not. I hope it's not, but it probably is. I didn't program the game. Right, don't get mad at me. I'm glad I didn't think of that right away. Oh, that's true, it is a type of boat. Yep, you got it. The game is saved. That was kind of a tricky one, though. And I would also have expected to have the word boat in there. Well, is this the? Foo to me. Not Don. I'll say again. Lose somebody. El Torme. They don't get any points for that. That just fills out the things. A Ted. Ben Vereen. That's a tricky one, too. Yeah. I'm the winner again. There's 0 points again. All right, final round. And I win my second prize in 2 games. We did the sailboat already, so I guess I'll do the cruise next and just work my way up. A place. Okay. The D this time, and let's go with, we'll go with A.
I switch it up a bit.
That's not helpful for me. Oh God. Wow, really? It says Juneau, Alaska, right? Gee, because I didn't pick the N. Oh no, I did pick the N. Fuck, what's another city in Alaska? Don't tell me in real life. Not Nome. No, it can't be Alaska. Fuck. Alabama. I don't have enough time now. Something Alabama. Did not win the grand prize. Mobile, Alabama. Hey, Chosen, how you doing? Another challenger in RPG land right now. I'm thankfully out of that right at this moment. So we're gonna be playing a minimum of 6 games. Good old Tales of Symphonia. So I already won one of the 5 prizes. I'm just going through the rest of them. But I have to actually win them. So that's gonna be the tricky part. But I mean, since every game is like 15 minutes long, like why not just go for it, you know? Hitting A, I'm hitting A to spin. How many of you figured out Mobile, Alabama from that? Or did you also get stuck on Alaska? If I would not have picked A as my vowel, I would have been really, really screwed. At least I had a moderate chance of picking that one up. No R, so it's not Rick. Not Rick. Yeah, I couldn't think of the city fast enough, and I wouldn't have had time to enter it once I figured it out anyway. It's a very, very short solve window. Peter's a dumbass, though. Waiting for your game to install? Which game are you installing? Is that on your new Xbox? Well, the last letter is probably N. I use Series S to install Redfall. I've heard a lot of mixed things about Redfall. Hopefully you enjoy it. I don't have the Xbox to even know. Why would you pick a U? Well, I guess the computer is picking all kinds of stupid stuff. Hey, BPN, how you doing? Saw you were playing some baseball. That can't be fun on the Wii. Oh, Redfall's on PC too? I didn't know. Yeah, the reviews have been kind of harsh on it. I rarely play games like the year they come out. Um, Except for like Tears of the Kingdom. I'm like 80 hours into that one. I feel like I should know this, but I don't. Oh, Game Pass is also PC. I keep forgetting that's a thing. I was trying to get to the L that's part of delete. Like, why isn't it letting me go there? Oh, Duke Ellington. Okay. My mind kept thinking, like, FUD? Like, what first name has a U in the middle? Gotta be FUD. Alright. Yeah, I usually don't either. I mean, it's if you're having fun with it, that's all that matters. And I mean, even, you know, the games on the Game Boy where I've ranked them like 5 or 6 out of 10, I still enjoy a lot of those. I mean, I enjoy the bigs, what BPN is playing, but I don't think I played it on the Wii, and that might make all the difference in the world. I'm pretty sure I played it on PlayStation 2 or 3 or whatever PlayStation console it came out on. I never really got into the Xbox controllers in general. I always found them to be like too bulky for me. I know a lot of people love them, but it's just not my thing. Too chunky and wide. PlayStation controllers seem a lot more streamlined. PS2, 360. Okay. Yeah, it was my roommate's copy at the time. So I don't have it anymore to double check. It's fun. Then I played a bunch of MVP 2006, I want to say, maybe 08. I played as it's like the second time I've hit bankrupt, I think. I played with the Cubs and had Sammy Sosa hit like 200 home runs in a season. And all of my pitchers had like, 20 perfect games each. Also, I could, earn the points to unlock every little special stadium and character and outfit combination and whatever. It's a good way to unwind after work. Yeah, I don't blame you. I honestly, I'm surprised I bought my PlayStation 5, but it was around like Black Friday and PlayStation Store, like the direct one, they had them in stock. Plus, Miles Morales and Returnal were on sale for deep discounts. I think like Miles Morales was like $20 and Returnal was like $30. So I'm like, all right, fine. It's like it's the most expensive impulse buy I've ever made in my life. Oh yeah, Starfield. That one looks pretty interesting. You use your free spin to buy a fa That's probably another game I will never play. I've watched people play Skyrim and Oblivion. I've played a tiny bit of Skyrim myself. I own Fallout New Vegas, but I've never popped it in. I thought that was going to be on the top. Oh, it might be cruise ship. Let's find out. Boom. Yeah, it does look pretty fun. If I had an Xbox, then maybe I would get it, but even though I love like open world games like that, the size and scope of like the Bethesda stuff really intimidates me to the point where I don't want to start it. Because I want to do everything, because I'm like a completionist. I don't know. I never wanted to get into Skyrim because the side quests never end. And I want an ending. I know there's a main story ending, but there will like always be things to do, and always kind of like bother me that the checklist is not complete. I don't know if Starfield would be the same way, but it messes with my compulsion. No, I'm not gonna solve. One T. Oh, hey, Wimburn. Sorry, I missed your comment there. I apologize for that. I'm doing okay. Yesterday, I was not doing good. I had a migraine and I missed the stream because I was sleeping like all night. I'm glad your exam went well. So that you're done now. So you're like on break. Oh, I need to pick a letter. Things move fast. I'm on game three of Wheel of Fortune, but I'm trying to win my second prize. They're going fast. I'm also losing my connection to the internet. Very cool. I get to see my parents on Monday. I will not be streaming Monday. Will be road tripping this weekend and then returning on Monday. But then I have a week off of work. So I'm. Oh, God. Should have picked that one. Okay, I know what it is. If I get a turn, then I get to solve. Oh, it was my turn? Oh, I thought I was waiting for his thing to run out. I'm dumb. Okay. Do I have enough time to solve? That's the big question. Nope. That was the U. Even. Yay! Oh yeah, after the George Foreman stream, I'm trying to decide what I want to play tonight. So what I've been doing recently is I've been doing Game Boy stuff during like the prime time hours, and then after I take the dog out and have like a little bit of food, I come back for a couple hours late night and do a general backlog, something that's not Game Boy. I was thinking I might do Rise of the Dragon even though I beat it on Monday, and I might just go for a better ending. Or maybe I'll just start something else, but I'm not sure what I want to start if I do. Oh God, I love the ear-piercing music. I would not have been able to handle this yesterday. All right, so 25,000 Hawaii, Porsche, and we're gonna try to win the cruise. The title, something, and the with A again. Well, that's pretty helpful. Here. Anna, I can't see. How am I supposed to plan? Shoot, I don't know it. And I don't know it. I don't know it. Yeah, Alabama. Once again, I did not win the grand prize. Androcles and the lion. Never would have guessed that. Even if I would have picked all of those letters on the top, I would not have gotten that one. All right, well. Okay, so you're. And away we go. Nope, I never heard of it either. I've taken classes on mythology or whatever in college, and I don't remember hearing the word Androcles, but I probably did. Evidently, dude fought a lion. Or helped a lion. Or ate one. Or invented it. Person, Androcles. I was really hoping it would be something very easy and simple. Oh well. Spin. We'll get there. We got all night. We got all night. Till my internet cuts out again. I sort of wish the computer was a little bit of a competition. I wish it wasn't just picking all of the garbage letters. It might help speed things up even more. You guys suck on one of the NES Wheel of Fortune games for 2 hours, even with help from chat? Really? This one doesn't seem like it's gonna be that hard. But it's obviously gonna take a few tries to get those final puzzles. I wish the time was doubled. They don't give you a lot of time to think. It's probably the biggest problem. Nope. Lots of bad luck in it being dated. Well, I'm old enough that it being dated is less of a problem for me. Like, I knew Ben Vereen, I knew Carl Sagan, I knew Some Enchanted Evening. But I'm not 4,000 years old, so I didn't know Ander Cleese in the line. I feel like Jeopardy is gonna be tougher for me. That kind of struggled on the Teen Tournament Edition. Some of those questions were really obscure, and then some of them were so ridiculously obvious that I overthought them and got them wrong. And there is very little in between. It's like so easy to. 5-year-old could answer it, and here's one that you need a college degree in that field to know. Still nothing popping out at me for this one. Could be a C at the beginning there? Oh. Spinning. This is a name? I definitely thought that B was going to be at the bottom for like Combs. Albert. Ah, okay. I broke my rule of buying a foul, but I definitely would not have gotten this as easily if it weren't for that. That you was crucial. And Albert was not coming to me as a first name that fit that. The and the And Lord Aberyth is also one of those smart people. So if he didn't understand Androcles and the Lion, then I don't feel bad. The cows. Cows of the wind. We'll see, there you go. Yeah, I get that. Oh, it still could be. Still could be the cows of the wind. Oh, I think it's the call of the wild. Let's get some more money though. Oh, just a 200? Come on. I shouldn't get greedy though. I'm gonna get greedy because the computer's stupid. And it also means less stuff I have to input on the solve screen. Alright, that's a whopping $300 I get for each L. What about White Fang? Alright, let's solve it. And my thing does not fit, but it's better. Right, host. So who's gonna be the new host of Wheel of Fortune? Now that Pat Sajak's giving it up. They're gonna give it to some random celebrity. All of the wild. Yeah. Probably somewhat awful. Isn't Pat Sajak like supposed to be kind of like a dick? Seems like he's full of himself. They'll probably give it to somebody like Ryan Seacrest or something. Yeah, someone who's annoying on the show. That's. I'm just trying to think, like, who's somebody who has, like, a bunch of jobs already? Like Steve Harvey. It'd be, like, somebody who already has, like, five jobs and he just gets another one. Oh, you're on TV a lot. Here, have more TV. An F. we'll try L next. Strahan. Yeah, he's definitely got a lot of them. What was that one? E? Oh, okay. Lord of... I feel like I'm close on this one, but I don't know it yet. Ah, okay, I know. I was thinking like Bonfire of the Vanities, but that's not it. Okay, so let's just do. Hated Carry First Big Rummy, you mean for Price is Right? Hitting 8 to solve. There we go. I really have not watched much of Drew Carey on Price is Right. But I loved his sitcom. I think I watched the Press Your Luck reboot. And Elizabeth Banks is really good on that. I liked Supermarket Sweep reboot with Leslie Jones, even though they canceled it. I thought that was a fun spin on that show. Alright, we're going for the cruise. Fictional character. It's fake. All right, so we know that there has to be an S, right? But P. No, try like a different stuff, and we'll try trial. Try Lil Abner. Gotta be a little Abner. I don't think I picked N. I didn't. Okay. Yay! We won our second prize! And my stream didn't cut out. You're All Dead as game shows and has shown the original prices right from the 50s. I've seen like one episode of that on like Buzzer. It's so much different. Price is Right is so much different in the 50s. When it's just like four panelists who just stay there the entire time and they just get prize after prize. It is really strange. SS Game Tech. I'm going on a cruise. I got myself a sailboat. Lil Abner is a comic strip that probably started in like the 30s. And might still be going on in certain newspapers. Another one of those benefits of being old. Yeah, for some reason I didn't think it could be L-I apostrophe L until after I entered my letter choices. Yeah, I think it is too. A lot of those classic ones are still going, but they just change hands. Like they, you know, the person who originates it sells off the rights to make new ones to somebody else. Sort of like how the Nancy comic is now in the hands of somebody completely different, and they've really made some fun changes on that. That's a very original, subversive, interesting comic. Same with like Heathcliff. I don't know if it's the same writer that's doing Heathcliff, but every time I see anything for that character's comic, that's some like off the wall stuff that they're doing. Like the gags usually take the entire week to really like flesh out, and it's just surprisingly counterculture. Heathcliff comics are. Or just like almost like anti-comedy. Go for a guarantee with the H. Alright, so I've played, what, four games of this total now? And the computer has not solved a single puzzle yet. End of. It's really weird that the computer always picks like absolute worst letters they could possibly. Not land of. I mean, it helps me win, but it doesn't really help me solve the puzzle because I have to do all the work myself. Might as well just play one player instead of competitive. Lavender ran from 1934 to 1977. There's a proposed revival in the 90s, but the creator's daughter objected. But he, I mean. How do I know of them then? Stopped in the 70s. They must have been included in some thing. Oh, look, the Y actually worked. Didn't expect that. Boo. It was in like cartoons and stuff, right? Like it's part of a, I don't know. Created Sadie's Hawkins Day? I feel like I should know that word, but I don't know what that word is. Kybor with like a C. Don't know what this is still. It's reprinted over the years with no new material. All right, Windburn. Yeah, have a good dinner. Oh, I think I'm losing connection. Can I pause? I can pause. Okay. I saw the wheel spinning on the stream. Yeah, hopefully you have a good dinner, and I'll keep playing until I'm done with the five games, or five prizes at least, so. Think I'm still up? Let's risk it. Let's keep going. No C's, so that's not that. What else would have an HY? Probably some made-up thing that I don't know. You know, some sci-fi term I've never heard of. This is a comic strip that ended in 1950s, which is why I don't know. So there probably is a D. I should have drawn for the D. The Ring of. Or maybe King. King of the. Maybe Kyber Soul with the K. What's the last word, though? Yeah, King of the I'm gonna buy the E just to see if I like is it rifles? Oh, I guess so. King of the Kyber. All right. I don't know what that is. I've heard of Kyber Pass, but I don't know if that's related to this or what. Back to Wikipedia you go. Whoops, I hit start instead of A. Person, Big Abner. Great, great letter to choose. It's a very smart one. So I know that like in modern Wheel of Fortune, the category person could be like a type of person, like an occupation almost, or like, you know, like mall walker or something like that could be a person. I think in this one it's literally like proper names. Novel by British writer Talbot Mundy, published in 1916, is about a secret agent in the First World War, adapted for film as The Black Watch. I've never heard of The Black Watch either. Maybe it's something that used to be taught in schools. Why is not a bad guess? Because that last word looks like it could be like pressy or something. I know All Quiet on the Western Front. I watched the Netflix version of that. That was actually, oh, two free spins in a row. That was actually really good. Oh, tease? Yeah, I'm using my free spin. Yeah, I'll take another free spin. No R's? Yeah, I'll use my spin. Could be Paula somebody. That doesn't actually help me. Not Paula. Ah, Pablo Picasso. It could have been Paula Pressy. Three. It's a little weird that there's only one version of Wheel of Fortune on Game Boy. It's also honestly a little weird that there aren't more game shows on Game Boy in general. It'd be cool to have a version of Double Dare. I know they released one. Nintendo. I'm not sure if I can skip the solve, but I am using it just to look at the puzzle a bit longer anyway. The soldier is a fortune. I'm gonna let him fail again just so I can
add another letter in there and make it easier on myself. Oh yeah, soft, please. S. L. E. O. O. Da, na, na. We got Hawaii. Gotta go for that Porsche now. Look at that sweet, sweet Porsche. Eeple. Let's do the L. Let's do a B. We'll do an O. It's not bad. I don't know it, that's for sure. I needed different letters. Massive. Just picked the wrong letters, so I don't have a chance. Kissing cousins. I guess an N would have. Yeah, I did not pick the N. N might have helped quite a bit. And the I instead of the O. Oh well, nothing you can do. Alabama cousins. Give me a second, I'm gonna take a quick little restroom break and I'll be right back and we'll try to win that Porsche once again. All right, I'm back. Did I lose connection? It shows I'm unstable, so I might lose it soon if I didn't. Let's get into it. Hopefully everyone enjoyed the lack of music in the game after the theme song is done. Of course. I don't know the first word. Not state. Send in state. I guess I can go with the guaranteed letter since this is a high dollar amount. Oh, okay. That helps. Something stock park, but I don't know. On there. Definitely not Woodstock. Oh, never mind, it's not stock. Candlestick. Whoops. Please have enough time to correct my mistake. And oh. Park. No longer exists. Ooh, that's a lot of letters. Same name. First time I've seen a same name.
It's weird they picked a legitimate letter for their first choice. Ronard, McDonard, and comes the boo. Don't tease it all. For Alabama. Still don't help. I mean, I don't know anything about what. Almost landed on the moo. How about a B? I know some of it. Shit. I don't know the top word. I also don't know the one that starts with the L. Neil, what's the first one? Here I am buying all them damn vowels just to figure out what the first word is. Richard? I don't know who Richard Diamond is. So Richard Diamond, Baseball Diamond, and Neil Diamond. But I don't know who Richard Diamond is. Maybe he wrote the sequel to the King of Kuiper Rifles. With 1,000 per letter, computer could catch up if I'm not careful. Richard Diamond, private detective. It's an American detective drama created by Blake Edwards. Oh. Interesting. Thank you for looking these up, by the way. I would not remember to do it afterwards. Out of nothing. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is still. Yeah. I don't know. I've never heard of whoever this is. Edwin Meese? They're gonna solve their first puzzle? No, they're not. Are you not allowed to solve if you guess a vowel on the final round? Maybe they just passed. All right, we're going for the Porsche again. Things. So there has to be an S. L, I'm gonna go with the D, and we're gonna go with an I. J. I know. I want to go like a little bit more A.
Astral. Astral. Oh.
On all three of the big radio networks, starting on NBC moved to ABC, then CBS for TV, starting on CBS went to NBC for the last season. I was close with gastric juices. Without the C, that one would be. That's. I should have done I guess. And I almost did C instead of whatever I picked. Some of those properties have to be close to public domain now. Someone can make a whole bunch of new Richard Diamond stuff. Actually, probably not if it's. Was on in the 60s. Got a little bit of time to wait. The power really does not seem to affect the amount of time the wheel is spinning. So there's no tease, so we know it's not shit on at all. No ends. This phrase is all just Z's. I'll have to look up my own trivia. Okay. Pick and, serious computer. I didn't actually think it was all Z's. One guest of all. Computer had more money, I had to go for it. On a risk, I'm actually solving a puzzle for once. What are people picking in the polls so far? Curious about the puzzle picks. Puzzle picks are pretty even. Voxel, Bugs Bunny, Stop That Roach, that's a brand new one. Yoshi, that'll be like the last Y game. Boggle Plus, more word game fun. Game 167 will be the third. Will mark, you know, like one third of the Game Boy library. Getting close. Never picked an S. Of all those turns you had. That turn. It's my turn. Oh, someone's joining in the Jurassic Park fun. Jungle Strike? I really like Desert Strike. That was a lot of fun. There are very few, Q, what the f- There are very few platforming and action games that I'm scared of at this point, which is great. Puzzle games, there's a lot that I am scared of. Because of how long and difficult they could end up being. Yoshi's actually one of those. Oh, L's. Three free spins in a row. Come on, you got some Ridiculous. Alright, and a 700. Come on, give me something good here. Could be like Sadie Thompson, perhaps? Thinking back to the Lil Abner, Sadie Hawkins thing. Maybe that's what's in my mind. I've never heard of Sadie Thompson, but it fits, you know? Let's try it. That's right. Sadie Thompson is a film? Oh, I got it. Gotta play. Just okay. First, the main character from Rain by W. Somerset Maugham. Several adaptations of that story exist with that title. Miss Sadie Thompson, a 1953 movie starring Rita Hayworth. Hold. Yeah, I'm not... 1928 film starring Gloria Swanson, 1944 musical starring June Havoc, 1997 opera, and then there's a Sadie Thompson. So they're leaning into their obscure shit. Wow. That is a lot of R's. I'd like to believe that the last word is store. I was hoping that maybe it would be like corner store or something, but nope. You're back. You missed something I had to look up. Sadie Thompson. Fictional character, Sadie Thompson. Should have guessed the E. Stood there. Welcome back, Wimber. I'm still trying to win my third prize. I think this is try number three for the hardware store, perhaps? We're learning a lot about 1920s stuff that is on a 1990s Game Boy game for children. Maybe it's from playing games like this that I learned about some random... Still gotta get that Porsche. It's a person. George Washington, does that fit? it didn't. It was worth the shot, I guess. That's rough. Okay. Such little time to think about this. You pretty much have to know what it is before you start putting anything. I did run out. Putting all my eggs in the George Washington basket. Oh my god! Yeah. Honestly, if I would have guessed O and D, I might have had a chance. I probably would have spelled it wrong, though. There's a reason for Sadie Thompson to be in a game from the 90s. The film was thought to have been lost for years after Swanson's death in 1983. The sole known surviving print of the film was discovered by her estate. Interesting. Yeah, he's a Russian author. I think he did Crime and Punishment, right? Henry Storton got a new score, has been released on DVD and Netflix. Boy, a lot of your success really boils down to picking the right letters in that final round. I was hoping it's George Washington. I think it was two letters too long for it to be Washington, though. Brothers Karamazov as well? Okay. I've heard of that one. Oh, I didn't click spin again on time. Well, I thought I'd be, but I might get done with this sooner. Maybe after walking the dog, I'll just come back and finish this up. I might have to do it in two groupings. Midnight. I've never read them. I just know of them. But, maybe something to look into for your next term. The classics literature class. That's something I would never take personally. Not much of a reader.
that's coming to mind on this yet. Maybe the first word is in F. I don't know if this is one of these ones where it's like a actual name or not. If it is, it's somebody I don't know. I think it's like Stanley Gardner, but I don't know what the first word is. Oh, Earl spelled E-R-L-E. That's not something I would have expected. Okay, don't know who this person is either, but I'm sure they're from the 20s. Glad I'm breaking my policy of not buying vowels. But I am saving it till it's like absolutely necessary for me, personally. There was actually a V? Best known for the Perry Mason series of detective stories, but he wrote numerous other novels and shorter pieces in a series of nonfiction books. Oh, so he's the author of Perry Mason, creator of Perry Mason. Okay. There are several Perry Mason TV movies for the podcast that we could be watching. I have not seen any of them, so... If I had, then I'd probably recognize the name. I think the wheel spin noise needs to have a little bit more weight to it, a little bit more bass. It's on the show, it's like such a heavy rumbling sound. It has gravitas.
Popping up in mind yet. What of 1.2 million words a year? I mean, I guess when pulp magazine writers were literally paid by the word, it makes sense that he would try to, like, set his own salary that way. Can't imagine having enough ideas for that kind of stuff. Got it. I'm gonna try spinning at least one more. Yeah, that's also true. I mean, if that's your entire job though, spending like 8-10 hours a day trying to do that. You know, you're raking in the big bucks. Do you think, are they gonna solve their first puzzle? They are not. When I was younger, I had an idea of like starting by typing a one-page story and then trying to expand that one-page story to 2 pages and then 2 to 4 and keep on going. But yeah. That felt like too much work. I think about doing a lot of things that I don't do. This I'm still doing. I also wonder how much more beneficial that would be, right? Because if I have a good story idea, then I should just create like an outline and just go for the full first draft and the start, you know? Like that's what writers typically do, is they have like the outline, they have the bullet points, they have the 3 acts, and then they just flesh it out right from the start rather than like doubling the length just to double the length. So it would be like an interesting exercise, but I don't know if it would make for a better story. But I don't have a good story idea to start with that anyway. Haven't really asked my mind to do anything creative in that way in a long time. It's a Hulk Hogan. Is. Yeah, very true. Every person has a different process. But since I haven't developed or actually used a process at all myself, hard to say what would work for me and what wouldn't. I just know I've never actually started a project in that way. The winner to win that Porsche now. Oops, I accidentally chose the 25,000. Whatever. Event 4th of July. I'm just gonna go with the basics on this one because I really don't know. Nope. I honestly can't even think of what one of the words is going to be. Mardi Gras Parade. You knew parade? That's impressive. Again, if I would have picked an A and a D instead of some of the letters I picked, then I might have had a chance. And flob. It's okay, I didn't want to win the prize anyway. I didn't choose the Porsche like I was supposed to, so. Flobbing platforms, flat plat, flabbies, flabby plats. I didn't even pick a letter. How quick it goes. Too busy itching my eyeball. Go with the guarantee of the H. That last word, snot house? Gotta be snot house, right? Why? Maybe if I get like any of the letters in that second to last word. I got a lot of money. Let's just buy something, I guess. Oh. Is it, you have it? I do not. Oh. Invasion of the body snatcher. Okay, the eye helped. Computer didn't get to pick their V. That's why. What's, wait, what? Why does it say a C there? Why did it switch to D? D wasn't even on the table. But when I typed C, it switched it to a D and would have made it wrong anyway. And I couldn't go back. They snatched my letter. See that now it looks as a C, but it was definitely a D before. Alright, well I got it. Don't mess with me, Pat. Any jokes on your way out the door? What the hell are you doing picking valid letters? Thank you. That's more like it. You know, I don't think I've seen a single version of Invasion of the Body Snatchers. Probably should, but all of them just seem way too hokey. I might know everything except for the no, I might, I think I know all of it. I'm gonna buy a vowel just to reduce the amount of stuff I have to put in. Guess I'm gonna win. A is probably, yeah, they're both the same. Both the same. Cubs fans know that one all too well. In. It's not an and. It'd be the. The rate's unstable again. Done. I didn't think there'd be S's. Art something.
Port. Don't know what the last word is. I think it's Fort Apache the something. They could solve it, but they're not gonna win because they don't have any cash. Apache the. No, like it. What's the last word? Frond something? Any options? The Brony? That can't be it, right? That's even a thing. Either. Feel stupid about this one. Fort Apache, the Bronx? The thing? Like those are two. Okay, I mean, I've heard of Fort Apache, I've heard of the Bronx. I didn't know. It's a movie? Then you'd think I would have heard of it. There's like a whopping three letters on the board there. We're left. People. Do a T. Do a T. N. We'll do R. Paul Newman movie from 1981. Huh. Well, I hope I get this one. There's a decent amount of letters on the board here. Tampa Bay Buccaneers, perhaps. Yes, three down. You do not have much time after you figured it out either. Film was the main inspiration for the series Hill Street Blues, huh? A little surprised I didn't hear about that one. There's my Porsche. I love the color scheme. Right, three prizes down, two more to go.
Not bad. Not bad at all. Is the movie supposed to be good? I never saw Hill Street Blues either. Ooh, let's get started. I think that might be on Hulu. Hill Street Blues. Yeah, getting closer. I thought I would be done by now, honestly. I thought these games would be go fast enough and that I would be lucky enough in the final round. But thankfully the computer is not a factor, it's just like a... I don't have to worry about actually winning against the computer, I just have to play. A little slow for a cop movie. Yeah, cop movies of the era don't always age too well. Just because it's like one of those things where... current movies have upped the ante so much that going back to what has been done in the past, even if it was groundbreaking at the time, it's been done many times since then, and you kind of like lose that oomph. Bankrupt again. Come on. That's not a bad cast. Not until Lethal Weapon came out. I mean, that one turned cop movies into like a... that was like a full-on action extravaganza. I think French Connection is another example of one where it kind of loses a little bit of its appeal these days because like the rough and tumble cop who does anything to get his way, you know what I mean? Like that type of character, the anti-hero that Gene Hackman plays in French Connection has been done so many times before, but it was a very novel idea back then. So, you know, it probably blew audiences away in the 70s when they didn't have anything to compare it to. Now you have hundreds of movies where the same type of thing happens, and so the thing you point to is the car chase scene, which again has been done with more elaborate, better special effects with faster cars and whatever since too. Yeah, and then you have Beverly Hills Cop, which has... I'm assuming that Fort Apache the Bronx is not meant to be a comedy, but it has like the same type of a... Yeah, I know what you're getting at there. I need to catch up on that series because they're making the sequel, right? Coming to America 2, I don't know if anyone else saw that. That wasn't terrible. It could have been better, but it wasn't bad. I've never seen all of Blues Brothers. That's another one that's like a blind spot that I should fix. For someone who went to film school, I really have seen very few of the classics. This is... I don't know what this is. Skip the sequel of Blues Brothers 2000? Yeah, probably. I appreciated what Coming to America, the sequel, did in terms of like bringing back the characters and everything. I didn't like the main character, his son. I thought he lacked a little bit of charisma. I kind of wish that Eddie Murphy and his Arsenio or any of the other people who were in that cast could have like done multiple characters in the same way again, just kind of like expanded their reach. Oh, you should watch Coming to America 1 at least. It's actually still good. It still holds up in my opinion. Which isn't always true about comedies. But I still think there's enough there. Keep looking at this thing and I keep on thinking Gosling, like, but that's not it for multiple reasons. What? You're supposed to buy a vowel that helps me. What number Beverly Hills Cop are they on? They're on like... This is gonna be number 4 or is this gonna be number 5? Gasoline engine. See, this is the problem with this version as well. It's like it allows you to spin when there are no consonants left. The manual says that it's not supposed to be happening. Number 4. I'm pretty sure I have all the other ones burned on DVD somewhere. I mean, legally copied. I mean, I own actual legitimate copies. I certainly didn't rent things from DVD services back in the day and burn them and send them back. Bankrupts. Don't know it.
I gotta say, this is a nice, relaxed change of pace from George Foreman. Oh, there is a Y. You contributing. I'm not contributing at all. Booty store. Nailed it. It's probably pretty close. I think it's beauty store. No, it can't be. Star isn't on there. Shit. Salon. I'm just checking the manual. I have all this dead time to see if I'm right, in that the game says some money. Yeah, hints on gameplay. When all consonants have been placed in the puzzle and only vowels are still missing, you'll be permitted to only confirm, buy, or solve. That is bullshit. That is incorrect. When all vowels have been placed in the puzzle and only consonants are still missing, you'll be permitted to confirm only spin or solve. That might be true. I don't think we ever reached that situation. But it is definitely letting us spin when there are no more consonants left. Nope. Not beauty salon. Alvin. Really? I'm for vowels. Not gonna try to get cash to be surprised. Yeah.
Oh shit, you solved one! That is the very first puzzle the computer has actually solved. But I still win, because they're dumb and they bought vowels. I wasn't close to getting it. Well, thank you, computer, for letting things go a little bit faster. Now let's see if we can win a trip to Miami. Or, I'm sorry, Hawaii. Person. Debbie Gibson. Exactly, it is about time the computer did something. This could be... No, it's not. Not gonna get time. Person. Irving Berlin, not close. Oh, I'm gonna win the entire state of Hawaii? That'll be good. I could use that. Alright, one more try, and then I'm gonna have to break for dog stuff. And food, and then I'll come back and I'll see if I can... finish this out tonight. So I won't be able to stream Monday, like I was saying before, and this is my last streaming day of the week, typically. It'll be nice to get this one done and start fresh on Tuesday with Bart versus the Juggernauts. Miller is an H. Okay. First word is throwing me off. Title. Over the. It's over the something. Something. Probably some classic novel from like the 40s or 50s I've never heard of. Guess it could be a song title too. Think is it gonna have a F? Thought maybe that'd be like the second word or the third word. I'm trying to think of letters that would go in front of R. Obviously, B is also one of them. Over the Brooklyn Bridge. Don't say it too loud, or the computer might get us. Thank you. Do I have cash right now? Yeah. Do. On to things. Well, I hope you don't solve it. Toots. Something tests. Assumed. Schools. Oh, that's cool. Scholastic aptitude tests. I'm just gonna spin so I can hopefully fill in less stuff with the time remaining. Damn it. All right. No way, he's catching up. Oops. Didn't mean to do that. I honestly, I accidentally thought I was pressing A to get to the point where I could select a letter. Bald. I'm getting there. I've won 3 of the 5 prizes. I just keep failing on the final puzzle because a lot of those require you to pick the right letters to have a legitimate shot at guessing things. And I'm just picking wrong. So I've won a sailboat, I've won a cruise, I've won a Porsche. I just need to win a trip to Hawaii, and I need to win $25,000. So, after this game, I'm gonna take a break and come back to it in a little tiny bit. Some food, walk the dog. something senior. A jazz singer. Took me a while to figure out like what that bottom word could be. Solve. I'm hitting A for solving. Yay. Alright, let's see if I can win myself a trip. People again. Okay, that's not gonna be good. Alright, what's L? I go with C, and I'm gonna try O. Pittsburgh Pirates is another sports team. That's not, because that should have been an A. Pittsburgh Steelers. No, that's not right either. Penguins. Didn't have enough time. It was Penguins. Ah. The time to enter it in is so short. I got it eventually. Yeah, the only way I could have had a better shot at that is if I would have actually picked the N instead of the C. Well. So that's it for part one of Wheel of Fortune.